Dear VLOGTOBER, day 13. Woo! It's been such a long week, but I am grateful through it all. Shout out to all my new subscribers. We are at 242 subscribers. Woo! The goal definitely is 300 by the end of VLOGTOBER. It may not happen, but we working on it. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe.
What's good, everybody? It's your girl, Nightmare, be your motivation MC, and I'm here to help you get to where you wanna be because I'm living my dreams. And I am here in the woods right now. Just excited about the journey that I got going on. Well, I guess today is the day. I finally got my keys. So I started already. I already had a client on Monday, but I guess today is really, I mean, not really, really official, but today's kind of official, me really getting in there. I got a client coming in tonight. So today, and I'm excited. I'm really, really excited to start this new journey back in the salon. Ooh, more professional, you know what I mean? Now I can start hosting my trainings in the space and my classes, and I'm just really excited about everything, and also, like, you know, just nervous, naturally nervous. You don't know what the outcomes is going to look like or anything like that, but I'm the one that's going to create what the outcome is going to look like, you know what I mean? How big I push myself is how big it's going to get. So I'm super excited. If you guys want to book your appointments, come see me. You know, I was in my house, so I wasn't really pushed. I never pushed myself. When since I had my son, I have not pushed my business. I have not pushed myself or anything like that. I just, my clients just always still came, still blessed me, still supported me. So I'm blessed and highly favored that I didn't even... I'm blessed and highly favored to know that I don't need a salon to eat. I don't need a salon to grow. Like, I don't need a salon. But it will be beneficial to have a salon for other people. It will be beneficial to to have training classes where I could get 3-4 girls in there. You know what I'm saying? And all train you guys at one time. It's just more professional. It's just better. It's just better wholeheartedly to be in a space. And like my dad was saying, I'm in like a party little community. You know what I mean? So I'm excited to get back in the world because I have literally turned into like this introvert, guys. I'm not telling no lie, y'all. I have turned into just this bug who loves to be at home in the bed with her son or in the living room watching movies, y'all. Last night, me and Harlem, we watching Jeffrey Dumas. Oh my gosh, y'all. I didn't think I was gonna be captivated into a movie because I'm not a big movie person. I'm 100% YouTuber. I literally watch YouTubers all day long. But when I tell you that Dunmar joint, that joint was crazy. You mean this fool was eating people's hearts? How many more other people are there out there like that? You know what I'm saying? Like, he was the one that was caught. You know what I mean? Like, how many, all these missing people, missing children, and all of that kind of stuff like that? Like, shoot, you never know, man. But, yeah, like, I just became such this homebody. With me still being able to have my business at home, it just was good. It was good. But everything don't last always. And if you want to grow, you got to take your business to the next level. So it's bigger and better from here, you guys. I'm just doing different things to inspire the next person. Somebody going to see me and they're going to get inspired. You know what I mean? I done seen other people. I done seen, you know, other people or whatever. Tierra J open up her shop. You know, different girls do different things. And that's what I plan on doing. You know what I mean? I plan on continuing to grow as big as I can. So right now, I just choose to be back in the salon. I'm so excited. I've been seeking therapy, which has really been helping me. Honestly, you guys, and it's so crazy that I literally had to have a baby to start seeking therapy. But once I had my son, it's like, I got like 2 times depressed. Like, oh my God, it just was, I couldn't believe every day was a struggle. You know what I'm saying? Every day was hard, you guys. Every day was hard. From me closing up the salon, the pandemic, me pregnant, you know, by myself, alone, you know, so it just was a lot. And it's still a lot. It's still very hard to, it's still not easy being alone, you know. Even though I do have my son, which he's amazing, but it's like I'm still doing this all by myself. And that's not what I wanted. But it's just how it happened, which is a lot of girls' story. You know what I mean? Like, no girl lays up with this dude and y'all talking about kids. You know what I mean? Y'all talking about being together. This is what y'all talking. But then as soon as the baby comes, that's it? That's dead? All that shit is done? Damn. So, you know, I'm still dealing with that. It sucks. But, I mean, I see my son every day. And it just is a reality for me. But it's okay. You know what I mean? But yeah, guys. I'm about to get dressed and finish my workout. Woo! I'm about to get dressed and I'll be back on here later. Do you guys like my nails? Ooh, nails by Tierra. Thank you, Tierra girl. I appreciate it. Tierra did my nails yesterday. I told her I just wanted a new tan. Fall is here, so something that's not too over the top, but just something that's, you know, very nice. I'm not going to tell any lie. A part of me wants to go back to her and ask her if she can add like a V over shape. I actually really might do that because I do have her phone number. So I may text her and be like, girl, can you add a V shape design on my nails? Just like a little added service, honey. So yeah, I may do that. I may go back up in there and get that done. Because even though I like it plain, I think I still want that V over shape. Just to kind of spice it just a little bit. I'm trying to pretend like I don't be liking my spice and edge. And I really do be liking my spice and edge. So, yeah. But anyways, you guys, I will be back. Cheers. What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Naima, being your motivation MC, and I'm here to help you get to where you want to be because I'm living my dreams. And I am back on my new camera, iPhone 14 Space X, whatever this phone is called. And when I tell you, this camera quality is so good. Now, it's not the Sony ZV-1. It's not the Sony ZV-1. But I will say that it's good. It's a good camera. It's a good camera. I love how it blurs everything else in the back out. I love how I'm the main focus. And I love how it's really just a camera. You know what I mean? Really just a phone. So I'm super excited to get into these vlogs, baby.
And yeah, let's get into these videos. I just really, today was like my official day one in the salon. I just got a whole bunch of orders. Do you guys want to see? I got a whole bunch of orders for clients. I got a whole bunch of lashes. This right here is my pixie curly hair. It just came in. I got some pixie curly hair. I got my blonde, some blonde wigs for a client. Lace, like, super excited for these orders. Thank you everybody who bought. For the rest of the day, I'm pretty much gonna clean up for the rest of the day, for the rest of the night, clean up, edit a video. I wanna get like two more videos out before October 1st. So it's Vlogtober, so I'm just like, I can't even believe it's Vlogtober. It's just so much, you guys. So I'm super excited about everything as well. I do need to like focus on looking at this dot here, because this is you and that's me, and I don't really want to be staring at myself the whole time, you know what I mean? I want to make sure I look good, you know what I mean? I want to make sure I don't have nothing in my eyes, but the focus is to talk to you. So I could actually really feel like I'm talking to somebody. You know what I mean? You get what I'm saying, girl. You know what I mean, girl. I mean, girl, guy. I say you guys. That's my little thing. But I'm excited about my new camera. I'm about to go to the tunnel light. It was a pretty penny. I actually paid for it flat. So it just was like, okay, Naima, you got to make something out of these vlogs. Like, okay, we need you, like, you guys, these are my lashes. When I tell you all, one of my lashes had bent, and I was like, ugh, because I slept in it. I was like, oh. Then I remember going to this award ceremony, and this white lady, she had these lashes, and she said, I've been wearing these same lashes for years. I said, what? She said, yeah. She said, all I do is put some dish detergent, so I just use this detergent. And my fingers, I got all the glue off, I washed it, and I let it air dry. When I tell you, my lashes fluffed back up, you guys, I've been wearing these lashes for about a week now, okay? I'm just gonna be going on to next week, and the week after that, and the week after that, with just my lashes, honey. I didn't go get them done. And baby, they are done. They are dead. Don't come for me. Don't come for me unless I send for you, baby. But yes, honey, it is definitely giving. I'm loving this camera. So let's get into these vlogs, baby. Let's see how long this lasts. I'm not gonna totally lie. I kind of do miss my camera. I like the quality on it, but it's something about having the actual camera. The camera actually really does a bigger filter on the face more than this, but I do like how it blurs out the entire background. So we'll see. I don't really need a filter, but I do like a filter, and this doesn't give the filter that I wanted to give, but it's good. We like it. We're gonna see. We got like maybe like 2 weeks to really try it out, because if I don't like it, I'm just gonna go back and get my phone. I kind of do miss holding the phone, but anyways, this might be the best thing for me. So tell me what you guys think. Tell me how you like the quality. Tell me if you think, Naima, go get a camera. Tell me what you think I should do, because baby, honey, I'm liking it so far. So let's go. What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Naima, Be Your Motivation MC, and I'm here to help you get to where you wanna be, because I'm living my dreams. And we are back. Harlem is here. We are back with another video, you guys. And today is, what's today? Alexa, what's today's date?
Today is Friday, September 30th. Would you like to begin your day with guided mindfulness meditation?
Yes, please.
The skill.
I need that, honey.
Deep meditation. Mindfulness of breathing.
I definitely need some meditation. Mindfulness of breathing. Yes.
Okay,
honey, enable everything, meditation. Girl. So
welcome to deep relaxation.
We're getting dressed right now. Bitch, is you still talking? No.
All right, here is your meditation.
Where is it? Oh, okay, there we go. Good morning, everybody. Meditate with NB. This morning, I just want you to breathe in and give a sigh. Breathe out. One more time. Breathe in.
To prepare for this meditation session, finding a place where you can sit comfortably and where you can practice without disruptions. You can sit on a cushion or meditation bench on the floor or in a straight back chair.
I'm getting home. I'm ready for school right now.
During this session, we will use our breath as the primary focus for our attention. We are not trying to get
rid of Alexa, fast. Stop.
Thank you.
Okay. Just give it to God. Let him use you, Alexa. Let him use you. I'm drinking my water. Woo, that was good. What time is it? It's late. So I'm about to take Harlem to daycare right now. And right now I'm about to get his clothes, pick out his little outfits for today. Honestly, it's getting a little cold, so we probably do like this little suit because it's getting kind of chilly. It's getting a little chilly, so we're gonna have him wear his little fit today. Little top with his little sneakers just because it's getting cold or whatever. So, and that was clean. So, come on, buddy. And this is my son, Harlem. Say hi. Say hi. I want to do some fun things this October. Y'all gotta, like, help me come up with some ideas. Watch out. Help me come up with some ideas of some things to do. I just got my nails done, so that was one thing. But I gotta do something. I feel like October's that month that you just take it to the next level. You know what I mean? Ooh, my breasts are so big. I look and see I got this thing tied on top of my breast. Chat. So you guys, I caught up on the Jeffrey Dahmer case. I feel like I've been watching. I feel like for the past couple of days, I've been watching. Like just even last night. Yeah, the past couple of days. Really, the past couple of days. Because last night I started watching like his own interviews and stuff. Then I started seeing all of these memes and not really TikToks, but I don't be on TikTok, so it definitely wasn't TikTok, but I guess it was like some shorts or whatever, since I be on YouTube, of like girls saying that watching crime stuff helps their mental health. Is that true? Like watching crime stuff, watching that type of things, help, does that help cure your mental health? Like, I don't know. Like, I'm just asking. Like, I'm asking. Because, honey, I'll take any kind of natural remedy. I'm trying to feel like you can watch me, like, get dressed in 10 minutes. So... I start with my lashes. Make sure those are on. I use, this stuff is so good, you guys. And these are NB hair, NB collection
lashes. I used the doozy lash adhesive. I love this lash adhesive. I don't like you. I used to use hair glue, but I don't use hair glue no more. I use lash glue. It just works better. I like it better. It lasts all day. It don't be coming off. I feel like with the hair glue, it come off. You be like itching at it more. Then it just coming off. You want to let it air dry a little bit. If you want to, you could put your blow dryer just to get it a little bit more tacky quicker. Remember, we getting dressed in 10 minutes. F1. Am I done? Am I done? Is that 10 minutes? I don't know. I'm not. I don't yet. Final touch. Let me see. You did it! It's 10:50. Full face beat. Eyebrows. I did it. Come on, focus. Full face, hair makeup, full face done in 10 minutes. Welcome to VLOGTOBER. Go ahead and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let me just add some edges. I don't even got no edge stuff. I just want to let the shop. Let me go. I look good. This is what I'm going to do. Do that. Let my hair do that. That look good. Let my hair do that. Okay. Yeah, I did that. Thank you, girl.
I want to share with you how to reach your goals. I think the Bible is the greatest motivational book ever been written. Now, I want you to repeat after me, please. We got to recondition our minds first. Let us say together, good things are supposed to happen to me. Yeah, write that down. I want you to say that to yourself every day. See, we live in a world where we believe that bad things are supposed to happen to us. I remember at a point in my life, Bishop, when things are going good for me, and I said, this is too good to be true. Something is bound to happen. Guess what? It did. Thou shalt decree a thing that shall be established unto you and shall accomplish that whereunto it has been sent. Watch your words. Watch what you say about yourself, about your affairs. Be conscious of that on a daily basis. Why? Because your words are powerful. In the beginning was the word. Life and death is in the tongue. Watch what you say. Never say I'm broke. Say I'm overcoming a cash flow problem. Claim what you want, not what you don't want. So affirm, good things are supposed to happen to me, and begin to believe that. begin to expect that. Now, I was talking to my oldest son, Calvin. We were going for a walk. And I said, Calvin, do you want to be successful? He said, yes, sir, Dad. I said, okay. We kept on walking. Then I stopped and I looked him in the eyes. It's my namesake, my junior. I said, Calvin, we're looking at each other eye to eye now. Do you expect to be successful? Given the fact that you are a single parent of two kids, given the fact that you decided not to go to college to further your education, given the fact that you are very talented, but you're behind on your dreams and your bills, do you expect, based upon your performance, based upon what you produce at this point in time in your life, do you expect to be successful? And Calvin got quiet. Because see, if you ask most people at the Manpower Conference, do you want to be successful? Do you want to live a life of productivity? Do you want to live a life of contribution? Do you want to be a better father? Do you want to have your own business? Are there dreams you want? Everybody will say yes. But see, want shows up in conversation. Expectation shows up in behavior. See, I can tell what you expect by what you do. That's why the Bible says, judge a tree by the fruit it bears, not the fruit that it wants. Not the fruit that it talks about, not the fruit that it claims, but by what you are doing. See, what you do when you leave here, when the music stops, when the shouting dies down, your behavior, how you conduct yourself, writing your goals down, deciding to enroll in school to get a GED, deciding to sit into class with children young enough to be your grandchildren, decide to find some product, some idea, some service that you can provide so that you can begin to create some value for yourself so you can create wealth. And let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, it's very important that we begin to learn how to create wealth. I'm not talking about loving money. See, I believe that lack of money is the root of all evil. People are steal for money. People are killed for money. People go to jail for money. Every time the unemployment goes up, in those areas where the unemployment is high, that's where you have the highest incidence of crime and violence. Whenever the unemployment goes up 1% in our community, 10,000 children and women are battered. One, money makes a difference in your life. I never wanted to be rich. All I've ever wanted to do was to be comfortable. How many of you ever wanted to be comfortable? Raise your hands. Then I realized in order to be comfortable, you got to be rich. An old friend of mine, Zig Ziglar, said, people say money won't make you happy, but everybody want to find out for themselves. Rita Davenport said, money ain't important, but it's right up there with oxygen. And let me tell you something, fellas, even if you're as homely as I am, if you got some money, women will find something cute on you. He got earlobes like Denzel, honey. Money makes a difference. I used to be so broke when creditors would call a house, my children would answer the phone and say, my daddy say he ain't home. I was so broke at one time in my life, I walked by a bank and tripped the alarm. I tell you, poverty sucks. You hear me? Repeat after me, please. I'll never be broke again. Yes, write that down. I affirm that I'll never be broke again. Never. Never will I ever be broke again. Let me tell you what money does. Number one, it gives you control over your life. Write that down. Number two, it gives you options. Three, it allows you to live a life of contribution, to contribute to things that you feel strongly about. Choose not to be a common man. It's my right to be uncommon if I can. I seek opportunity, not security. I do not wish to be a kept citizen, humbled and dull by having the state look after me. I want to take the calculated risk, to dream and to build, to fail and to succeed. I refuse to live from hand to mouth. I prefer the challenges of life to the guaranteed existence, the thrill of fulfillment to the stale calm of utopia. I will never cower before any master, nor bend to any threat. It's my heritage to stand erect, proud and unafraid, to face the world. Luke 12:34, where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. So what do you love to do? And then explore ways in which you can earn a living doing that. Cooking, writing, painting, working with numbers, working with people. The other thing is, not only must you have knowledge, talent, some skill, but the other thing that's important, faith to act on whatever your dream is. See, if you don't believe in yourself, how many people you know that have a lot of talent, a lot of abilities, but they don't believe in themselves? Raise your hands. See, that faith is very important. So the faith to act on those dreams, those desires. Here's scripture that I like very much. Proverbs 16, 16th chapter, 3rd verse. Commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. Commit means to carry into action deliberately. Commit means to make it happen no matter what. Commitment, the difference between next time you have bacon and eggs. The chicken was involved. The pig was committed. He had to give it all up. That's going to take a minute to sink in tonight, all right? See, when you make a commitment, I'm going to become wealthy. When you make it important, when you decide I'm going to do it no matter what, life changes for you. See, most people don't keep their commitments to their commitments. That's why they lead lives of poverty, lives of misery, lives of unhappiness. Socrates said, the uncommitted life isn't worth living. So part of what you must do, whatever commitment, whatever covenant you make with God while you're here, to go back to be a better father, to go back to make a difference in the community, to go back to change your life, to decide not to ever to use drugs or alcohol again, to decide to bet that you're going to begin to recreate yourself, that you're going to be reborn to a new state of consciousness. Whatever commitment that you make, keep your commitment to your commitment. No matter what, if it's hard, then do it hard. But keep your commitment to your commitment.